Hi, welcome to Datylon. Today, we're going to show you how to make a dot plot in Adobe Illustrator. Dot plots are really fascinating charts. For example, as you might know, in a bar chart, a value is visualized by the length of a bar. In a dot plot, the value is visualized by its position on an axis. Typically, the bar chart's numerical axis should start at zero, but a dot plot doesn't need to follow this rule. We would need to use the minimum and the maximum values in the data to define the length of the axis. Actually, we wrote a really interesting article about it. Make sure to check out our Datylon blog and read about dot plots and other charts, as well as common dataviz practices. You can also find the dot plots resource page in our Datylon chart library. It's full of valuable design tips that can help you to make your own dot plot. Today's tutorial is also available in the form of an article you can read on our blog. You can find all links in the description below. To create a dot plot, we're going to use the Chartmaker plugin Datylon for Illustrator. Downloading and installing the plugin takes just a few seconds. Navigate to our website, www.datylon.com, click on Get Started, and create your free account. You will always have free access to our web app and your account. When you join the platform, you will automatically get a 14-day free trial. No credit card needed. Make sure to download the plugin and add it to your Illustrator. In this tutorial, we'll make a dot plot that shows how the mood in the top 20 happiest countries in the world changed between 2018, 2019, and 2020. The public data comes from the World Happiness Report 2021. Make sure to download the data using the link below. Let's start by preparing the artboard in Illustrator. For our design, we can work with 1,000 by 1,000 pixels. You'll now want to select the Datylon for Illustrator icon in the toolbar. Start by drawing a rectangle. Don't worry about the size, as we can easily resize charts with the Datylon plugin. You will now notice the Datylon window appears on the right. Here you can select a chart you're interested in. In our case, it's a dot plot. If you click on the tile, you'll see a few different types of dot plots you can choose from. We'll go with the first one. The next step is adding some data. You can now see the Datylon editor window. Let's start by clicking on Manage Data. Now select Add, and in a drop-down list, click on Import File. This is how we add a locally saved file from our computer. Lastly, click Select Sheet. As you can see, our dot plot updated with the new data. Now we have three columns. Each column represents one variable, country, year, or happiness score. In our design, we want to communicate the difference that occurred in the happiness ranking per country between 2018, 2019, and 2020. Our data is sorted based on the happiness score from 2018. The higher the rating, the higher the country's name will be on the categorical y-axis. Thankfully, binding the data is not needed in this particular design, as everything is already in its right place. So we can already start with styling our dot plot. But first, let's define our color palette. We could use predefined colors, but as we would like to use the same colors as the World Happiness Report, it's better to create a new color group in Illustrator swatches where we can add our custom colors. We'll use these colors for chart elements and for our labels. You can find the color codes in the description of this video. I've already added this color group previously. Now that we have our colors ready, let's change the icon from that circle to a vertical dash. To do that, we can go to Styling, Data Marks and Symbol, and next to Icon. We'll choose Square Solid. To make it look like a dash, we just need to adjust the size. Make sure the link icon is turned off and update the width to 3px and the height to 24px. As for the color, we'll go to the palette we created before. The last thing to do here is to update the connector. Let's change the color to cyan and thicken the strokes to 2px. As we are ready now to improve our labels, let's go to Categorical Axis, and under Labels, we will change the typeface to PT Sans Bold and the size to 20px. This will help better view the design on mobile devices. Lastly, we'll change the color of the font to dark green. As you can see, the names of the countries are sometimes centered and sometimes even in two lines. To fix that, let's stay in the categorical axis. Actually, the paragraph section has by default applied a length restriction to our labels. If we turn it off by clicking the eye icon, it will remove the restriction and fix the appearance of the labels. Now we can add a grid to the categorical axis. It'll help improve the readability of the chart. To add to the grid line, turn the ticks and grid on. Keep ticks turned off, as we don't need them, but turn grid lines on. We will set the color to gray and the weight to 2px. Now we could make it a dashed line by clicking on the cogwheel icon. Set the dashed line to 2px and the gap to 15px. To have a more accurate reference, we need to reduce the interval size between the labels. Go to the numerical axis, major ticks and grid, and turn on custom ticks amount. Let's set the tick interval to 0.2. If you look at the numbers, they don't look too good and aren't clear. So let's change the starting tick to 6.2. Now it looks better. But we still see that one of the labels overlaps with the chart element. We can avoid it by adjusting the vertical offset for axis labels. If you scroll to labels, we can set the vertical offset here to 25px. We can already change the font size to 20. We want to make sure that it's as clear as possible across different devices and media. Here, we can also update the color to dark green, picking it from our color palette. We're almost done, but there are still two very important elements to be added to our chart, a title and a source. To add a title, we use the Illustrator's type tool. Let's select the area on top and type the title. We will change the font to PT Sans and the font size to say 36 and the color to cyan. The title gives the context and indicates how we should read the chart. And in our case, it can also function as a legend. We can do it very easily. Let's select 2020 from the text. Select the eyedropper icon and click on the red in the chart. And now, 2020 is colored in the same red color corresponding to the dot plot. We can make it stand out even more by making it bold. We can change the font to PT Sans Bold. And we'll do the same for 2018 and 2019. This way, we're able to add a pretty nice title legend to the design. Another thing is the axis scale. Currently, we see it ranges from 6.2 to 7.8. But the full scale ranges from 0 to 10. We need to clarify that by adding a subtitle. Let's use the Illustrator's type tool again. We can place a text box under the title, use PT Sans Italic, 24px size, and the color will be cyan. Last but not least, we're using the data we downloaded from the World Happiness Report website. It's necessary we add the source, so we can do it exactly the same way as we did the subtitle above. And there you have it. We created a beautiful dot plot in Illustrator. Remember, you can easily scale any chart by simply resizing it. And when you're done, you can export the chart exactly the same way as any other Illustrator design. You can also export this chart to our Datylon web app and start collaborating on the template. Make sure to visit our inspirations page on our website for more chart ideas.